who's dead.
Tim.
Oh, look, I've got a message on your answering machine. Talked about a funeral.
Where have you come from? Jesus, this is a shock. Where have you been all this time? How long is it?
8 years. You know, all over, really.
Oh, I'm on tie duty. Judy said someone would forget.
Yeah, well, give me a chance, mate. I only found out about half an hour ago. Who is it anyway? Or is it was?
Stuart.
Stuart? Oh, fuck. You might have said on your machine, mate.
Nick's coming. Boyfriend. See you.
Family?
No. Well, yes.
Are you not sure?
No, I am. I don't know why I said that.
You look tired.
Well, I didn't sleep much last night.
Because of the funeral?
No. I never sleep much.
Perhaps you're anxious.
I don't think so.
Depressed.
How would I know?
How would you know?
Well, I've often wondered if I'm depressed.
Because you've never been happy?
Well, maybe. I'm just not sure what people mean by the word.
Happy?
No, depressed. But happy, too. And when you asked me if I was depressed, I felt strangely flattered.
Because you think only interesting people are depressed.
Yes. I suppose I have emotions, but I don't make a meal of them. Do you know, the Maoris have professional mourners who get the whole thing swinging. Everyone else stands around looking appropriately miserable while they do the athletics.
Has no one close to you died?
Yes. Well, no, my father. I don't know how close you're supposed to be. He was my father, I suppose.
You didn't feel sad?
No, not really. Perhaps it's delayed shock.
When did he die?
20 years ago. It's a hell of a delay. I once faked a broken heart, but I ran out of energy.
I'm sure you have many deep feelings.
Well, you might be disappointed then.
I had a lover once. A married man. He was like you. It was like he was not living his life, but watching it like a comedy. He wanted to be with me, and he wanted to be with his wife and children, and he was afraid to make a choice. Well, no, not afraid. He could not, because he was not in control of his own life.
I suppose the thing is, when you're young, life is like a boulevard, you know. It's wide and full of possibilities, and everything seems open to you. Et maintenant, c'est comme un petit chemin avec les murs.
La vie est devenue étroite.
Quoi?
Life has become narrow.
Yes. It's like that moment in a whodunit. When you worked out who did it, and there's still 50 pages to go.
I feel more free now.
Really?
I had a crisis and the walls came down.
Well done.
Well, you know, some people prefer the walls. Freedom is a little bit frightening. You have to make a choice. The question is, the life you have, is it the life you want? But it's not easy to change. I think it needs something dramatic, a crisis. And courage. Most of all, courage. Will you look after my bag, please? I have to go to the bathroom. Yeah. Thank you. Oh, thanks for doing the flowers. They're lovely. My pleasure.
Been shopping.
She's a friend of Stuart's.
I don't think she is.
Really? I didn't ask. She's from France or London. She's certainly French. Do you mind taking this? Judy's looking a bit, yeah.
Minutes. I'm amazed about all these savings. Before you came along, he was always borrowing off us. And we had an overdraft.
Do you have a will?
Well, it's different for us. We've got kids. Do we have anything to leave them?
Has that bastard phoned about the fertilizer yet? Hello, Nick.
Hello, Dan.
I'm off now.
Oh, there's no need.
No, I got things to do.
I'll show you out.
See you.
Yeah.
No, he hasn't phoned. Nick, I will be fair, you know? Oh. I think I can make this work.
Good.
Assuming they'll wait another month.
Another month? Are you taking into account Stuart's money?
Well, I don't think we need to.
Well, why not? We may as well. Do you know how much it is yet?
I just don't think we should be thinking if it's our money.
What are you going to do with the money? Hide it in the mattress?
I think you should go to Nick.
Why on earth would you do that?
I just think that if Stuart made a will, he would have left the money to Nick.
Sorry, but I just found this absolutely extraordinary. Nick's a nice enough chap, and sure, he and Stuart were pals and cohabited for a while, but it's your decision. It's your money.
Dan, we always said what's mine's yours and what's yours is mine.
Well, in that case, I'm giving Nick an enormous amount of money, and I don't know why.
It's Stuart's, and Stuart loved Nick. Can't you understand that?
Well, I understand the concept. I understand that they shared whatever it was. But you can't compare that to what you and I have, or even to what you and Stuart had. Don't be so bloody daft.
If you could see some of the photographs, read some of the diary entries, and I'd hate just because we can't do a bit of financial jiggling not to respect that. I think it would be nice to give it to Nick.
Well, I think it would be extraordinary to give it to Nick. Nick's young, single. He has no financial difficulties, no responsibility. Here we are, unable to even to vaccinate our cows. Maybe we should get Nick to vaccinate the cows, since we're giving him money.
Dan, you're being silly.
If you want the truth, I don't consider the relationship between Nick and Stuart can possibly be described as meaningful.
I don't want a row.
Well, let's discuss the possibilities of who else we could give it to. We could give it to Tim, or we could go down the road and give it to whoever. It's just as sensible as giving it to Nick. Just because they shared photographs.
Listen, Dan, it's my job to do what I think Stuart would have wanted.
I totally agree with you. He was your brother, and you must do what you think is right.
Now I feel bad.
Don't feel bad. Feel nice. Have you mentioned it to Nick?
No.
Well, you might want to think about it before you do.
with these. I have to get them in, you know, so they don't fly away. Okay, I see you. Bye. Give you a list. Nick's coming over this evening. I haven't got time.
Hello.
Hello.
What have you done to the kitchen? It's different.
Who are you?
This is Tim. He's a cousin. His dad used to have this farm. George has got his old room.
You can have it back if you like.
She's joking.
Where's your farm?
Yeah, where's your farm?
Where's your farm? I've had 22 fucking years of this farm. I mean, I remember that calendar. Why's nobody taking it down?
They stopped sending new ones.
When I got Mum and Dad to adopt you, I thought you were going to leave when I did. You just kind of let life happen to you, don't you? Don't you remember what Stuart used to say? Go for it.
Stuart drowned.
Where's David?
He's underneath the loader. Don't worry, we'll have it fixed in no time.
This is the one you want.
Oh.
It's the best.
Oh, right.
It's the greenest.
Oh. Good. That's settled then. Mm-hmm.
I would like to have a coffee, but I have to meet someone. Would you come for dinner on Saturday, 9 o'clock?
I love cooking.
Are you vegetarian or do you eat fish?
I eat anything.
Oh, then you'll come.
Why not?
Do you have some paper?
Yeah.
£4.30. Bye then. See you Saturday.
Yeah. Why didn't Tim take over the farm?
Oh. Tim's father didn't trust him. Tim always said he didn't want to anyway. David wasn't family. So he rang us, because we grew up on a farm. And when Stuart said no, I had to persuade Dan.
If you want to stay, it's what I want. But if you decide to go back to London, is money a problem?
How are you, Nick?
Fine, thanks.
That all you bought? What happened to the list?
Oh, the list. I lost the list. How's Tim?
He's having a party on Saturday.
Saturday? Perhaps I'll pop in.
What, at the party?
Why not?
I think you might look vaguely ridiculous at your age in that mob.
Hello. You too.
Yeah. I just needed to escape. Thanks.
I had a quick whip round the party. It's not really my kind of affair. And I told Judy I'd be late, so I thought it might be nice to have a few moments alone, you know, about the kids and family. Well, cheers.
Cheers.
Can I ask you something?
Mm-hmm.
Were you faithful to Stuart? I mean, was that part of the deal, or was it more casual?
No, we were faithful.
Yeah, but presumably not to the same degree.
As?
Well, as Julie and I, for example.
No, it was the same.
Well, isn't there some sort of understanding in your field?
About?
You know, casual sex. Because with our lot, there are certain formalities.
I don't think it makes that much difference.
No. But with your lot, there seems to be a lot more of it.
So one reads.
What would Stuart have done if he found out you were having an affair?
I don't know. Probably he'd have left me.
You know, as you get older, you lose the knack if you don't keep your hand in. I mean, ours is a happy marriage, and everything is as it should be. Yet there's still a longing. At the end of the day, I suppose it's a question of courage.
Courage?
Well, you know. Seize the day. Risk it all.
I think it's more to do with consideration. So you'd have to think about what you were jeopardizing. And I just knew that I'd never be able to do it. But maybe that's just how I am. But I don't think it's to do with courage.
Yeah. Courage. That's the word.
You got a tip tree?
Well, I can do.
I could report you. Yeah, you're supposed to have a meter.
Oh.
But I won't. You're not a cab driver at all, are you?
No.
Coming in then?
Well,
we could do it here if you're shy. You don't wake up my mum.
No.
Do you know what a French twist is?
No.
Well, pull it down your seat, because I always end up banging me head when I do this.
All right.
Enjoying it?
Well, I slipped out and I had a drink with Nick, and then gave some drunken youth a lift home.
Nick?
Yeah, he thinks the world of you. Well, we all do. Birthday.
Oh, I don't know. I feel funny.
We always go there for your birthday. Anyway, I've already booked.
Have you and Nick fallen out?
I think he's met someone.
Really? Already?
May not be serious. Someone called Charles.
Sounds pretty upmarket. Maybe this Charles has some money. Have you told Nick what you're doing yet?
Dan.
I'll have the steak, medium, and these two are having burgers.
Veggie burger. Vegetables?
Yeah, and me too.
I don't know why you put up with him.
Doesn't it come with vegetables?
I don't know. What would you like?
Charlie?
Oh, I'll do it.
Who's she?
That's her.
Oh. Ooh. Champagne. Shall we?
Here it is. Sorry about the delay.
No, that's all right. We were enjoying the entertainment. We see you've got a new waitress.
She's just helping out.
Well, we thoroughly approve, don't we?
Sorry, I'm late. Happy birthday. Do you want to sit down?
These are for you, for your birthday.
Who are they from?
I bet you thought I'd forget.
Oh, what a surprise.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you.
Who's dead?
Stuart. Oh, fuck. You might set a new machine.
Nick's coming. Boyfriend. See you.
You're Tim, aren't you? Stuart used to talk about you a lot. I'm really glad you made it.
I'm still in shock. I was so looking forward to seeing him again. Oh, hang on a minute. Have you got a spare room?
Well, there are four of us.
Oh, yeah. Oh, congratulations.
He's eight now.
I've got a spare room, I suppose.
Well, I don't have much stuff. It's just a rucksack and some things at my parents'. And I don't even know how long I'll be staying.
Well, neither do I.
Do you want her? I mean, when I go back to London. She was always Stuart's dog, really.
Oh, we don't need to talk about that now. Dan and I want you to think that this is your house. You can stay here as long as you need to. Are you sure about letting Tim have this room?
Come in, come in, come in. Ignore the dog.
Oh, I wondered what happened to this. Does it still work?
No. Oh,
maybe Dan could mend it.
Well, I think we lost the screen. Stuart's films are in that drawer.
No, we've got the screen. We thought we'd lost the projector.
What's your name?
Her name's Ruby. She was on the boat. Managed to swim ashore.
I went round to Dad's. I couldn't believe how much stuff I had. That's lovely, thanks.
I never knew Stuart kept a diary. I never did when we were kids. Who's Lucy?
Oh, that's me. It's short for Lucifer. Old Nick, Satan, Lucifer. I will let him use him.
Well, you told me to make you a cup of tea.
Oh, Nick, you're not throwing this out, are you? I remember when Stuart bought it.
He's a cousin of Stuart and Judy's. To be honest, when I offered, I didn't think he'd say yes.
Have you thought about our offer?
What offer?
Coming to stay with us in London.
Oh, no, I couldn't face it. It's kind of you, but couldn't face it. And until Stuart's money comes through. Judy says I can stay in the house for as long as I need to, which is good, because I think I just need peace and quiet at the moment.
Michelle.
somebody smashed the vase.
Oh, don't worry, mate. We'll glue it back. Listen, you look a bit tense. Why don't you take the dog for a walk? Go for a drink. Get a tenner off David.
Hi. Is this Tim's house?
No. But it's his party. Excuse me.
Yeah.
That's my jacket.
Have it then.
Excuse me. Hello. Hello.
You got any tea? Who are you?
I'm Nick.
Have you seen Darren?
Darren, red shirt?
Fuck knows.
He left last night.
Oh, not again.
If I ordered you a cab, would you be able to direct it home?
Not until I've had some tea. And toast.
And toast. Hello, I'd like to order a cab, please. Yes. Never mind. Are you doing what I think you're doing?
I'll be very quick.
Well, I've got your clothes. There's your tea.
Did you sleep with me?
No, you were unconscious and you seemed to be spoken for.
Darren. Actually, I suppose I never really thought about that. Darren, my boyfriend. My boyfriend, Darren. That would mean Charlie and Darren. Darren and Charlie, yeah.
I'll get you a cab.
Am I annoying you?
No. It's just, you know.
I think I might stay because you're being so nice.
Where do you live?
I haven't got any money.
How much do you need? No, I don't know where she lives. Thank you. The sooner the better. You want to go home, drink plenty of water and lie in bed all day. It'll take another Alka-Seltzer in a couple of hours.
I'm going to call you Dr. Nick because you looked after me.
Well, thank you. Bye. Bye-bye.
Did you miss me? I left the money on the table. Now, how am I going to get it back to you?
Oh, don't worry. No, it's nothing.
Of course I'll pay it back. I'll have to pay it back.
Well, you know, if you're passing.
I'll ring the bell.
Yeah, or put it through the letterbox.
Morning. Who cleared up?
You're late.
And so are your customers.
Excuse me.
What are these like? So I've always wanted to try them, but they are so expensive. Dr. Nick! Over here! Dr. Nick! Come on! It's £9.50.
We have to do this. God knows what I'm supposed to be looking for.
Thank you.
How's Darren?
I don't know. My hangover's gone.
Well, it's been a week.
So who knows one of these at the party?
Yeah.
Was it a flash silver one?
Yeah. What are you doing?
I said I'd pay you back.
Yes, I don't want you to pay me back by
cheque. Shush! You'll get me into trouble.
And what about me?
Have you got two previous convictions?
What do you want?
Where's Nick?
At Stuart's.
Where does Stuart live?
Stuart's dead. Where did you get that?
I found it.
Yeah, in the fucking cutlery drawer. Give it back, you thief.
I'm off.
Me too.
You can't go. You've still got customers.
The last bus goes in 20 minutes. And what's it got to do with you, anyway?
I'm so sorry. The chef's just left.
It's all right. We just want a drink.
Yeah, but this is a restaurant.
So?
Well, so it's illegal.
Well, we'll eat something then.
But the chef's just left.
Nick, Darren's come to apologise. Have you met Darren?
Yes, he tried to steal my jacket.
As well?
As well as what?
Nothing.
Darren, you've got to apologise.
No, it's all right. Wasn't me he left naked and unconscious on a stranger's bed. Do excuse me.
I'm really cross with you. Why did you leave me?
I thought you were following.
Well, I wasn't.
I didn't know that. I was pissed.
Can you think of any reason why I should stay with you?
I'll call you tomorrow then, yeah?
Piss off and lose my number. Not you. Do you make lots of money?
Well, we manage.
We?
I used to have a partner.
Stuart?
Yes.
This is lovely. Do you want to go to a club? I can never quite get rid of him. For good, I mean. My dad says I'm going to marry him. He says I'm that stupid.
What does your mum say?
Well, exactly. She ran off with the Cadbury sales rep, so who's he to talk? I liked my mum. Thank you for looking after me. As most people don't, you know. Put up with me, just chuck me out.
Well, did try.
Of course, if I'd known, I wouldn't have messed you about so much. About Stuart, I mean. Are you sure you don't want to come to a club?
No, I'm tired. I'm going to bed.
Well, I've got an E. You can have half.
That's what Stuart used to say.
What did you used to say?
No, I'm tired. I'm going to bed.
How did you meet Stu?
I was out walking, actually. In a park in London. So was he.
You said he hated walking.
Yeah, it wasn't really that sort of walk.
Not in that part.
Can I come in now?
No! Answer the phone!
Hello?
Oh, hello, Judy.
Listen, sorry, I didn't get back to you the other day. I've been oddly busy. Listen, I got someone here at the moment and we're about to eat, God willing. No, no, it's nobody you know, I don't think. Charlie? No. No, it's nothing like that. No. Okay. Bye.
It's unusual, isn't it?
So far.
It's hard to get the coconut to really blend.
Or the shell. Come in.
Hi.
Oh,
I'm Charlie. Who are you?
This is Judy, Stuart's sister.
Make yourself at home. Cake. Is that for us?
So, Charlie's a girl.
Yeah. It's all a bit peculiar, really.
Nick, I've been meaning to talk to you about Stuart's money. Oh. Dan and I have had a talk and we've decided it's needed. You can stay as long as you need, just let me know.
I will. Judy, I've been wanting to talk to you. Do you have time?
No, I've got to pick up James, sorry.
Where the hell have you been? You're 20 minutes late.
Jeffrey's mother's visiting. I couldn't get back into the house.
Why don't you sack the fucker? What's going on?
Oh, hello, Nick. What are you doing up?
Can you turn the music off, please? I was trying to go to sleep.
Sorry?
Yeah, well, sorry isn't good enough.
But what else can I say?
You can say you'll go somewhere else. When I said you could stay, I thought it would help because Stuart liked you, but it hasn't, and I want you to go.
What, now?
Yeah, that's fine by me.
Nick, it's 3 o'clock in the morning.
I'm well aware what time it is.
What? I'll go tomorrow morning.
Do you promise?
I don't want to stay where I'm not wanted.
Is that a good idea, being on your own?
Well, I don't think he was a very good idea.
Well, what about London? I mean, isn't it time?
Must be very lonely down here. Well, anyway, I can't afford to move back right now.
Why not? Hasn't the money come through yet?
I'm not getting Stuart's money.
Where's the vinaigrette? And can you slow down?
In front of you and no.
Breakdown. What's she doing?
Your job.
I don't know why you part with him.
Miss me?
It's only for a night, I promise.
Tim, sorry if I was out of order the other night. And, it wasn't just you.
No, it's all right. It was Charlie, really, wasn't it? We had a chat. She's after you. But I told her she was wasting her time.
Remember Steve? That boy who picked me up in the club that night, he walked out in a strop? It turned out he already had a girlfriend, only she'd gone to Brighton for the weekend. Anyway, I saw him again last week in Woolworths. I mean, he works there. And he said he dumped her. Or she dumped him. One or the other.
Do you want to play a game?
What?
I pretend to be you, and you pretend to be me.
You never say anything.
Shall we start?
What did you say?
Tim, aren't you? Stuart used to talk about you a lot. I'm really glad you made it.
Excuse me, mate. I think my dad's just about to have a heart attack.
So, you finally run out of money?
So, in Vietnam, after a week, they're saying, you must come stay with my family. In England, you're pushing it to get a cup of tea. Mm. Do you know anyone who's got a spare room?
So they still sell soups in Oxford?
Where's your hippie necklace?
Round my hippie neck. So are you working here now?
Well, lending a hand, you know me. You cunt. 8 fucking years.
I wrote. I rang once. Got a woman.
That was Sarah.
Fuck your wedding.
Yeah, we tried to trace you.
I know. It was bad pads, malaria. Where is she anyway? She shaved her moustache off. So Stuart was gay. He used to pull more women than you did.
No, that wasn't hard.
I still can't believe he's gone. He was half the fun of this town.
Who was the other half?
Thank you.
changed.
You coming for a drink?
Nah, I've got to get up in the morning.
Come on. You're single now.
You what? I've been meaning to tell you.
Don't you know?
Will you just shut up? Get out. I shall attend to you in a minute. Shit, mate. I'd no idea. Yeah, it was messy. I'm sorry. Through it. I just wish you'd been around.
Get upstairs.
I heard he was having an affair. I bet he didn't tell you that. Oh, sorry. Need any help?
What do you think?
Tim!
Mum, I can't keep it a secret any longer.
Thank you. You coming?
Depends. Where are you going?
To Bannon's for a donut.
I'll see you there.
If there's any trouble, you know where I am.
Would you like to come to a party?
Excuse me. Hello? Oh, no, 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 that's fine, that's fine. Listen, I've got a question for you. A young man's just invited me to a party. Some would say so. Average. Clarity. I don't know. There's no way of telling. I'll ask. When is it?
This, Saturday night.
Do you hear that? She can't make Saturday night.
Well, I didn't invite her. Who is she?
My aunt. Okay. I'll see you later. Bye.
Well?
Let me think about it.
Well, hurry up. I've got a chocolate finger waiting for me.
I'm having a party. Saturday night. Oh, I don't know. About 9, 10 o'clock.
What do you mean you don't know who I am? We were at school together.
Because he met a girl and he pretended he was having a party, so now he's got to have one.
Well, bring him along. Now, how old are they?
Yeah, it's trying to impress him with how many friends he's got.
Party, Saturday night. Yes, party. Over there. Do I come to the party? Saturday night. Oi, how about you? Party, Saturday night.
No, but it's his party.
Take your eye, my hand. Stick this in here.
Because he met this girl and he's too shy to ask her out. So he said, do you want to go to a party? And she said, yes. So he had to organise one. You'll do that for me. You need to.
Where is she? Did she show up?
Yeah, of course she did. She's over there talking to Michelle. Bring her over.
There's a girl in my bed.
An experiment. She's out cold. Perfect.
So you're saying she turned up and she didn't say a word?
Michelle talked to her.
Michelle remembers nothing except she woke up with a huge bump on her head.
Yeah, well, talking about Michelle, I heard that you had an affair. And that's why Sarah left you.
He's talking about Michelle.
You know, I don't know what it is, but people just don't seem to send thank you notes like they used to.
I've said I'm sorry.
How did you get over the wall?
Not telling. Might need to do it again.
There was a spade in the shed you could have tunnelled.
I know, but I saw someone inside.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I don't want to talk about him. Also, someone told me that you organised the whole party to impress me.
Oh, really?
Yeah, well, the point is, you know, I've just got over a serious relationship.
I thought you didn't want to talk about it.
And I don't want to get into another one. You know, I just thought it was time I had some fun.
Well, I'm on for fun. What do you mean by fun?
Going to a lot of trouble.
Hold the wine, see if you can.
Now, in my experience, right?
Corkscrew's over there.
Don't say I didn't warn you. What happened to the good one?
It wasn't good, it was just fancy.
You lost it.
Got pinched.
What, your party?
Yeah, Nick was furious. He said it reminded him of Stuart.
Stuart didn't look like a corkscrew.
No, that's what I said. Stuart looked like a potato peeler.
I promise I won't stay long.
David, this is Leah. Leah, this is David.
All right.
Hello?
coconut curry. See if you can guess the missing ingredient.
Cheers.
Long time no see. I won't say I was sorry when I heard about Sarah, but I didn't gloat. Was it because of me? And did she ever find out?
No.
So you never told her how close you came to dumping her before she eventually decided to dump you instead?
No.
Canadian, wasn't it? She ran off with?
Have you finished?
I've hardly started. I've had 6 months.
Ta-da!
I need some water. Your friends are shit.
Isn't she lovely? She likes you.
Oh, he said he wouldn't stay long. Anyway, never likes my girlfriends.
He used to like me.
What? It was you. You and David had a fling.
Fling. Yeah.
We grew up together, and then his parents died when he was 12. So I made my mum and dad adopt him. Nick. Let's hide. It's like nag, 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 nag. Right, quick, be on your sofa.
Fling. You don't understand, it's for fun.
Nice view.
Sorry. Leah.
Don't be. I'm having a whale of a time.
Another drink?
No, it's all right. I'll go.
No, no, again.
No, I was going to go anyway.
Whatever.
Ice and vodka?
Yes.
No.
Just a cup.
What are you sorry about, exactly?
I almost forgot to tell you. Remember that guy I worked with in Prague? Posh boy, come under bars. Anyway, he's coming to see me. Didn't tell me what he wanted. Can you pass that ketchup? Real mysterious fucker. Good laugh, though.
Oh. How's it feel? Can you get a plaster? I kept meaning to. I kept picking up the phone. But in the end, I didn't have the courage. That's what I'm sorry about.
Oh, come on. What about that tranny cabaret outside Prague?
Oh, enjoyed that.
What the fuck are you doing in this place?
Do you want sugar?
Oh, yeah, two. I'll have to know by the end of next week. You can get the money off your dad.
Well, maybe. Anyway, it's not just the money.
You're not sure she'll come with you? Something in this coffee? What's going on?
Oh, no, Nick. What are you doing out?
Room will have to be cleared out. I don't know where you're going to put it all.
If you want to help, smile while you're doing it, because otherwise I'd rather do it on my own.
Oh, that's not what you said at 6 o'clock this morning. I need your help is what I remember.
I know your problem. You're jealous.
Jealous? Of you?
Of me and Leah. Of our relationship.
Oh, is that what you call it?
You had your chance when Sarah dumped you. Did you take it? No. You stayed at home and moped. You missed your chance, old son.
Over Justin! Here. Give me the ball!
Justin!
Quick.
Take him out.
Yeah!
Gotcha!
Go on, son!
Now get the other way, mate. Hey, grow up. Ow! What? Hey?
Do you know that way, when your parents ask you to come and stay, and then when you do, they make you feel like you're in the way all the time?
Not really, no.
Well, mine do. You know, I'd move out, but I kind of need a favour.
Favour?
Well, money. Do you remember I told you about that bar in Prague?
Mm-hmm.
Well, the same guys want to set one up in London, and they want me to come in with them. And that would mean that I'd have to move to London.
Oh, great.
So I said, well, it depends.
Mm.
what are your plans? Because I want our plans for the future to maybe involve each other. And this is where you're supposed to say that's a fantastic idea.
Can I help you? I'll have the special.
Yeah, me too.
Vegetables?
Whatever it comes with.
That was quick.
I'm not talking about pushing you about in a wheelchair. Change plan.
She turned you down.
It's Judy's birthday. I completely forgot.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy
don't pick up the phone because I won't be able to say what I want to say. You know she's yours, don't you? And if you don't go for it, then you're even more stupid than I thought you were. But I know you've seen her, so you've probably done all that shit anyway. Point is, well, well, that's it, really.
Help yourself.
Jeez, Nick. You scared me there.
I often come down here when I can't sleep.
But I'll ask Dad for another 1,000.
Why not?
Now, the last thing Stuart said to me before I left was, if I ever see your face again, I'll know you fucked up. It's him that got me into travelling, really. Go for it, he used to say.
You want me to pay you to leave? Last time you went away, you didn't come back for 8 years.
I didn't want to come back until I'd made enough money to return your loan.
You haven't returned my loan.
Oh, when you see Judy, could you give her this? David gave it to her. Didn't it, Carsley?
I suppose she was trying to lose it. But you never know. You know, when my mum ran off, I started to do some very odd things. I went out of control for a couple of years. Were you thinking of me or Stuart back there?
I haven't a clue. But I was jealous. Like you said, when I saw you and Steve dancing together.
Steve, I should call him. Do you think I should go out with him?
Charlie and Steve. Steve and Charlie. Why not?
I'll miss you.
Well, who says I'm leaving?
You will, won't you? Sooner or later. Don't run off without saying goodbye. Tell Tim he owes me a tenner.
Good time.
Hello, Nick.
Hi.
Take a seat.
Close the door. I hear you're batting for our side now. Here we go. I thought I was safe with her. And I thought if Stuart came walking back in, and I kept thinking he might, then you wouldn't mind. I'm sorry.
Here, let me. Used to have one of these in Prague. Can I borrow some money?
No.
I need £1,000. It's pledge money for this bar.
Oh. No.
What if I was to hang around and work here? How long would it take?
We've got David.
Suppose if farming doesn't work out, you could always become a taxi driver, from what I hear.
How many people know?
Only me. It's when I saw the nodding dog in the car, I realised it was you Michelle was talking about.
Well, sometimes you get these feelings and you don't know what to do with them.
What? With Michelle?
Ah, no, that was a lapse. She killed them. You should settle down, Tim. Have some kids. Get married, preferably.
I'm sorry, I was a bit harsh. Dan and I have changed our minds about the money. I know you'll need it if you're going back to London.
I think it's about time. Will you take Ruby?
Well, the kids would love to, but... Dan, do we want a dog?
Dog? What dog?
Stuart's dog, you know.
Well, no harm. Nick, I've been meaning to say, why don't you have the projector and the films and the screen? You ought to have them.
Thank you. Oh, and thanks for the money as well.
Judy, would you help me set up this thing?
So you got the money then?
Uh-huh.
No, I mean Stuart's money.
Uh-huh.
I told Judy she should give it to you. I never intended to stay. Then, for the first time ever, I wanted to stay here. Felt at home.
We'll get by somehow. Would have been nice to have had the money, but that's much less important than other things we've got. Isn't it?
How much do you need?
A couple of thousand. Ready.
Thank you.